Hello guys and welcome back to another episode of Voltz. Now I'm sorry I haven't uploaded in a while because it's mainly because my computer has had a breakdown and I had to buy a new hard drive and stuff. It was incredibly annoying. But on the good news, Voltz has had an update and it's added quite a few cool things in, and like this barbed wire, for example, which I've surrounded my compound in. I've changed the outside a little bit. I've added like a little garden. Not sure what I'm going to put in there. Maybe I could have something peaceful and like missiles, like flowers or something nice. I don't know. But anyway, well, I'm up here on the top of my tower just to show you guys the new missile launcher I've built. Now I've upgraded the old one and now it's red and all looks spiky and a lot cooler. Now to upgrade it, you basically just have to add steel onto it. It's not that much of a expensive upgrade, but it's makes it a lot more accurate. Okay, now I've got my radar gun here and I've got two other missiles. I've got the sonic missile and I've got the cluster missile. Now these are two quite high up tier missiles. They're the second tier and they're pretty destructive. Now I'm gonna go find a location to fire these at. Let's have a look. I think, how about here? This'll be fine. Okay, coordinates set. Right, let's head back. Now, as you may notice, I'm not jumping as high with my power armor suit thing, my Iron Man robot suit. I'm not sure what it is. It's a modular power suit, that's it. I'm not sure why. I think the update has changed the amount of jump on it, or maybe I just fiddled around with the settings or something, or did something wrong. Okay, but now the first missile I'm going to try is the sonic missile. So let's just put that in. Where can I reach the button from here? No, I don't think I can. Damn it. Okay. Let's try and find a place where I can see it as well. I guess I could just press it and then have a look. Right. Okay, so we're ready to launch. We need to put the coordinates in. Oh, that could have been a bit drastic if I didn't. Okay, and let's fire. Oh, damn it. Oh, God. Major lag. Where are you, missile? Let's see if we can get a bit closer. Might not be the best idea. But still, let's have a look. Oh, God. Holy. Oh. Well. If one of these lands on me, do I die? Oh, my God. That was... I'm going to have a lot of clearing up to do. Right. Yeah, so that's the sonic missile. Pretty destructive. Where's the hole that it hit? There. So it just kind of tore all the blocks out. I mean, it's not that much of a destructive impact. It doesn't go that far down, but yeah, it's kind of chucked a little blocks everywhere. If that was someone's house, you'd be pretty annoyed. I mean, I wonder if it does that with chests as well, so you can just go up to the chest and get all your stuff out. I'm not sure. Anyway, okay, let's head back up and put the next one in. Okay, jump over my barbed wire. Try not to get stuck in it, because barbed wire basically just... it's a bit like webs, it slows you down, but then it also damages you. Unfortunately, the bad thing is on this, that you can break it instantly, which is a little bit stupid. Not sure why that... Did that just take my boots up? Why do I have two... Is that a dupe glitch? I don't know. Okay, right. Is that ready to fire? Okay, let's just have a check. Same coordinates. Yeah, that'll be fine. Okay. Right, let me just double check. The coordinates are... Let's just put them in again, just in case. So I'm not exactly sure if I put down the right coordinates that time. But, okay, anyway. So the cluster missile basically is going to spread out into different explosions and basically cluster everywhere. Okay, so let's have a look at this. Fire! Oh, God, I'm getting lots of lag from these missiles. Where are you going? Oh, God! Oh, so it actually separates into... That's pretty destructive. Well, that was pretty awesome. Oh, cool. Collecting the resources. Okay, now the next part of this episode, because that would have been a bit of a short episode if I'd just done that, is I'm going to show you guys how to defend against a missile strike like so. Now, I built a little house up there, which is the place that I'm going to be defending it from. And I will see you guys in a second. Okay, guys, I'm now back at my base, which is where I'm going to start crafting all the stuff we're going to need to defend against a missile strike. Right, so first we're going to need an EMP tower. Now, if you guys don't know what an EMP is, it basically sends an electro current into the air and will stop any missiles from coming down, which is quite nice. I think it'll also stop electric devices sometimes, which is also pretty cool. And you can also have a EMP missile, which does the same thing, apart from if they have an EMP tower, I think it might knock that one out as well. So you can use stuff to get around the defenses. All right, so we're going to need some bat boxes, an elite circuit, a wire, a motor, and four steel plates. Okay. Right, we've got steel plates, and I crafted a couple of stuff pre-hand, just so I didn't have to waste my time crafting stuff that I'd already shown you guys. So what do we need again? We need the elite circuit in the middle, a wire, two bat boxes, and motor. Where are you, bat boxes? There. Four of these. One, two, three, four. And I have the wires on me, I believe, right? Okay, so actually, and just a helpful little option that I found out before is you can click the question mark there, and it'll actually put the recipe into your crafting table, which is quite nice. So you can't forget it. And I think I can use that wire there, hopefully. Right, and where's the elite circuit? I swear I got that out. Oh, I didn't get that out. All right, damn. Right, I can remember the recipe anyway. One, two, three, there. There. One of them. There. One of them there. One of them there. Okay, and now you've got an EMP tower. Okay, now the second thing we're going to need is a radar to actually detect the missiles that are incoming. Right, so let's have a quick look. Two pieces of gold, a radar gun, and a control or a basic circuit. All right, so I should have some gold in here. One, two. Do I have a spare radar gun? Or am I just gonna have to use this one? I'll just use this one for now. Right. And I think I have to empty it beforehand. So I've just gotta set my coordinates. I've gotta remember not to fire here because I'm gonna be screwed if I do. Right. And is it empty yet? Now, I've had a few problems with this being empty. It kind of like spazzes a bit and stays at 1%, which I think it'll still work at 1%, hopefully. Right. So what we need to do now is we need to put the gold there, and I can click the question mark thing, even though I haven't got all this stuff ready. One there, and so I need some basic control circuits. I need steel plates. Do I have enough? Oh, I only have one steel plate. Anyway, I've got these. Okay, so let's craft a couple more steel plates. One, two. There we go. Then we can put them like that. That like that. The radar gun there. And there. Now, is this radar gun gonna cause me some problems? It looks like it is gonna cause me some. Let me just. I've got the recipe right. I might need to build an entirely new radar gun. So bear with me, guys, while I just build one. Okay, guys, I've just built a radar gun with exactly zero power. I think it's because the other one had 1%. A bit annoying, but I guess I'm just going to have to use this one. Okay, put that there. One, two, three, there. That there. Okay, and now we have our radar station. And now the only thing left to do is just to go up to the place and actually attach it. So let me just get over there. Okay, guys, I've quickly set up the radar station and EMP tower. Now, basically, what I've got to power it is I've got an advanced energy cube, which is basically a way to transport energy around. So you can I charged it back at the base and brought it over here. Attached to a bat box because I've been having problems getting the energy cube power to go straight into the radar station and EMP tower, but that kind of just stops that problem. Okay, and now what I've done is I've attached the radar station and EMP tower with redstone. Now, you used to be able to just attach it with a line of redstone and that was it, but now it appears that it needs to have like a lever source or something to actually set off the EMP. So what I've done is I've just put a redstone inverter, so we've got a redstone torch under there, and basically that just allows it to work, which is quite good. So basically, on the radar station, we have the safe zone and we have the alarm range, and I think we're going to keep those as default for now. And then on the EMP tower, we're going to set this as 100. Okay, now as you set the EMP radius up, it needs more electricity. and you have different settings on it, but we want it to disrupt missiles, so we click on that. But you also have disrupt electricity, which will destroy like electrical devices like bat boxes and stuff, which we wouldn't want to do because it just cut the power to all this. Okay, and now the last thing I need to do is just attach, just put the missile into the launcher. Okay guys, and what I've done is I've quickly built a conventional missile because I didn't want to build something too big and just waste it. So let's quickly put that in. Okay, wait. There we go. Right. Okay, and also I've set up a massive redstone timer, so I'll be able to get there over there quite quickly. Okay, so let's have a countdown in 3, 2, 1, go. Job. And I've given myself plenty of time, so hopefully I should be able to get there before the launch. Okay, now what we should see is the EMP tower, and hopefully we should see this, a conventional missile coming on the radar. And I've set the alarm range at 60, and that's taken on the missile. You can see the little flary bits come off. So yeah, that's how you defend yourselves from missiles. And what I'll do is I'll set that up in my base so I can have a proper one, so if I try to get attacked, and also it actually drops a missile, so if someone's trying to launch a really powerful missile, you can actually just steal it off them, and then you're a missile up. But yeah, okay, I think that's the end of this episode, but I'd really appreciate it guys if you would give me a like and subscribe, and please remember to give me feedback on this episode, and if you want me to do more episodes. All right then guys, thanks for watching.